Welcome to Channel 17, the Town of Colonie Government Channel.
Hi, and welcome to Forum on Fire Safety. My name is Pete Lattanzio. I'm the chief of the Town of Colonie Department of Fire Services. And as you know, this is our show that we try to bring information to you folks about how to try to stay safe in your homes and to make yourself or have a safer living environment for yourselves. One of the things that I don't know if a lot of folks are aware of, that the Town of Colonie has over 54 square miles. It's one of the largest towns in the United States. And another thing that a lot of folks don't realize is the Town of Colonie has 12 volunteer fire departments. I know we've had a lot of folks moving into the town over the years, and a lot of them have moved out from the cities, and you know they're accustomed to having a career fire department available to them. But here in the Town of Colonie, like many of their surrounding communities, we're completely protected by volunteer firefighters. And with that said, my guest today is Chief Gerald Paris. Jerry is a past chief of the Shaker Road Fire Department. Jerry is also an operations car for the Town of Colonie Fire Emergency Services Office, and he's also a New York State fire instructor. And I think Jerry's going to bring a little bit of information to you today. And hopefully what we're looking for today is, if some of you folks see the show, you're kind of curious as to what the fire department's all about, maybe this will answer some of those questions. And we're always looking for new members to join the local fire departments. So maybe this will be that that information that will get you kind of interested in taking that next step. So I'd like to welcome Jerry to the show today.
Thank you, Chief.
Nice to have you here.
Pleasure to be here, Chief.
Like I've already said, we are protected by volunteer firefighters in the Town of Colonie. Why don't you just give me a little background about what a person would have to do to become a volunteer fireman in the town?
Well, first thing they'd have to do is go to their local fire department. And this as well as not so much the town, but as far as any county that's actually in the town, or I'm sorry, the county surrounding the town or any outside county or any outside locality. And what they would do is get an application. And a lot of departments, there's a fee of $3. There's a filing fee. They do a basic background check on you to make sure that you have had no prior convictions as far as arson is concerned.
And that's what they're looking for. They're just looking for arson-related type of things. Obviously, if there's other convictions there, I think that there might be some concerns. But the major thing is we're looking to make sure that nobody's ever been arrested for setting a fire before.
That's correct. If you've had traffic violations, it's no big deal. You know, some people have had misdemeanor arrests. As long as it's not an arson thing, It's okay. You know, we're human. We all make mistakes. We've made mistakes in our lives, and we need to correct those mistakes and move forward. And that's one of the things that the fire service allows you to do, is to be reignited or reinitiated into a family, because that's what the fire service is. It's a large family. It's like a second family to us. The Town of Colonie as a whole. You spoke before about being 12 different departments. Wearing the hats that I have worn in the town, the way I look at it, I'm a past chief of Shaker Road, but I look at all the other 11 departments as my brothers and sisters. They're all part of my extended family that I have an opportunity, not only as being a past chief of the fire department, but being a state fire instructor where I'm out in the county and traveling throughout the state, meeting and training and working with all the individuals, that it becomes a large family.
You know, it's an interesting point you bring up about being a family. Both you and I have been involved in the fire service for quite a few years. And there's a time commitment involved with being in the fire department, and I don't want to kid anybody about that. So you do spend a lot of time at the firehouse, either be it drills or at meetings or work details or actual fire events. So you do get to meet a lot of different folks, and you spend a lot of time with these people, and you're right, they do in a sense become an extended family because you do spend so much time with a lot of these people.
That's correct. And to enlighten a little bit more of the folks that are out there, the listeners that are out there, what it actually takes, as we stated before, is you fill out your application, they do a background check on you, they bring you in and they put you through a screening committee. And the screening committee basically will say, yes, you know, this person meets our criteria. Very seldom do we have anybody that doesn't. They come into our family, they're voted in on the floor by the membership, and now they actually become a voting member of the corporation after one full year of service. Mm-hmm. But going into that first year of service is required by the Town of Colonie Mutual Aid Plan Agreement that every firefighter that joins a fire department needs to go through what they call Firefighter One, which is sponsored by the state of New York.
What's involved with a Firefighter One? Because again, you know, I think there might be some folks out there who say, geez, I've really thought about joining the fire department, or I see things going on and I'd like to be a part of it, but I don't know if I've got the time to be involved in that. Mm-hmm. I know the first year is usually difficult because you are mandated to take Firefighter One. So what kind of time commitment would somebody be looking at for something like that?
Well, one of the things you got to look at is we need to get you scheduled into a Firefighter One. The Firefighter One classes fill up so quickly that sometimes it might take you a year after you've been in a fire service to before you can even get into a Firefighter One. The Firefighter One, as of we have today, is 87 hours. When we first started the fire service hundreds of years ago, the training was basically hands-on. We did it with buckets, and we've progressed. The fire service is like a rocket ship. If you're not on the rocket, you're going to miss the ride.
Mm-hmm.
The fire service, going back to prior to 2000, used to have a 39-hour training mandate, which was the old essentials of firefighting.
Right.
In 2000, they came out with what they called BIA, which was basic, intermediate, and advanced. The basic firefighter class went from 39 hours to 42. In 2004, they came out with the new Firefighter One series, which basically took you from 42 hours, but it included the intermediate session, which was another 36 hours, and they rolled it all into one class, which is now Firefighter One, which was 78 hours. In that 78 hours, they gave you your basic firefighting training. They gave you hazmat, which would be hazardous materials operations was in the class. Confined space was in the class. WMD, which means or stands for weapons of mass destruction, was in the class. And all this was grouped into one, and it went to 78 hours. Now, the state of New York changed curriculum last year, or the beginning of the year, and the Firefighter One class is now 87 hours. But in that, they're giving you a few more classes that are actually in there. You're getting a wider base of knowledge to keep you safe as a firefighter. Once you've completed a Firefighter One class, you have now initiated yourself to be part of that interior crew,
mm-hmm.
to actually be on the truck, which a lot of departments allow you to ride the truck, but they won't allow you to enter the building.
Okay.
Now you'll be able to enter the building.
I guess that's a question that I had, or some folks may have. You know, you mentioned that it may take a year to get into this class. So if I was to join tomorrow, am I going to be not doing anything for the next year? But I believe most of the departments now would put you in as an exterior firefighter, get you trained to do that, the basic stuff's outside, and we're not going to put you in a position to get yourself in trouble until you do take this basic training, but you're not going to be an idle person either. You're going to be an active part of that department.
Absolutely. One of the biggest things that you need to look at in that year time, a lot of times you can come in and be in a Firefighter One in class in a month later. That family that you just joined is going to take you under their wing. They are going to put you to work
mm-hmm.
the day you walk in that firehouse. They're going to get you to do the social aspect of things. They're going to get you to do the firematic aspect of things. You're going to go drilling, doing extrication drills. Once you've covered your nine core topics, there's nine core topics that need to be covered, you can actually go in and start burning before you do Firefighter One, because your training starts the day you enter that firehouse and you have been accepted by your new family.
Mm-hmm.
Your training starts.
Okay.
You're going to actually go on calls. You're going to actually help people when that 911 call goes out. You're going to be that person that's going to help answer that call. The senior members of your family are going to mentor you until you can get into that state Firefighter One class, which gives you your mandated training that you must obtain mm-hmm. per requirements of the fire department or the Town of Colonie Mutual Aid Plan. So you're going to go to work the day I joined.
Good. Now, with the new, and maybe you can correct me if I'm wrong, but with the state changing the curriculum in the past year, haven't they also gone to a part of this now where you're going to be able to do some of the training online, so you're not even physically having to go sit in the classroom for a part of that 86 hours? Some of the stuff you can be doing at home now?
That's correct. One of the things the new governor has put into place with the help of the Office of Fire Prevention and Control is they've come out what they call a blended learning program. Now, they ran a few pilots of the blended learning. One was in Erie County, which is out near Buffalo, and the other one was actually run right here in Rensselaer County, right next door. Mm-hmm. The results of the blended learning that have come back were excellent. What it is, it's for a person that's a self-starter. It takes that 87-hour class that you have to be there for 87 hours mm-hmm. and basically cuts it down to 60 hours of actual hand-on time. So what you're basically doing is you're taking all your classroom sessions that you would be sitting in there with the instructor mm-hmm. and you're taking those classroom sessions online. But some people might say, geez, I'm taking it online. What am I learning? Each one of your segments that you take online, you need to test out. So we're verifying that you're taking in the material. You're testing out that you've understood the material, and then we're putting your skills to test when we get you back as a student.
Well, it seems like that would be a plus, and again, I know everybody has a lot of things going on today, especially if you're, you know, you got a family, you've got kids that have to go here and there. It's kind of nice to have that little bit of flexibility now to be able to do that portion of it in your own home at your convenience. Maybe it's at night after everybody's going to bed or in the morning before you go to work, whatever, but it does give that flexibility to the student somewhat.
Yeah, yes, it does. If you look at, you know, 87 hours versus 60, it's a lot easier to manage 60 hours than it is 87 hours, especially when you're talking about being away from home. One of the key things with this whole blended learning is the initiative from the governor's office to actually make training more readily available for people out in the field, because they realize it's a time restraint. One of the other things that you need to look at with the whole programs that the state actually has to offer and some of the mandates that the towns and villages and cities put on their firefighters is every one of these state classes that are taken, mm-hmm. if you register as a student in a college that is running the program, Schenectady Community College, Corning Community College, Empire State College, mm-hmm. John Jay College. When you go and take that class in the field, that class, if you are a matriculated student enrolled in one of those programs at one of those colleges, you get college credit for every one of those fire classes that you take. We take Firefighter 1. If you as a student, you're sitting in high school, you're eligible to join a volunteer fire department. You can start your college career the day you join that fire department. That Firefighter 1 class is worth 5 college credits.
Yeah. I'm glad you brought that up because I'm actually a graduate of Corning Community College. I got my associate's degree through this very process. And, you know, you do have to take a lot of classroom work, so it's not all stuff out in the field. But all these classes that you do take all do generate credits that go toward your degree. And it doesn't cost you anything, which is a really, really great benefit to a lot of folks. You know, everybody's running into the same problems. Budgets are tight. And when you can go and end up with an associate's degree and virtually cost you nothing except for your time, that's a big benefit.
Absolutely. If you look at the changing demographics of the world today, economy starting to tight up, the price of fuel. It's a quick way for mom and dad to get their son or daughters mm-hmm. a college education with little or no money laid out. Yep. And who's paying for it but the state of New York and the fire departments that are actually out there. It's part of our budgets. We have training budgets. We have a training budget at Shaker Road where we can actually take firefighters and we send them to the State Fire Academy, which is out in Montour Falls.
Right.
The fire department's paying the bill. So not only does this young person or this individual, and I shouldn't say young because, you know, you can be any age just to qualify for this, but you're getting an education, you're learning a whole new skill, and you're giving something back to your community. You're taking this education you've got and you're bringing it back out onto the street with you, and you're serving your community with it. So it's really a win-win for everybody in this scenario.
That is so true, Chief. One of the things, I just, you know, talking about serving your community, one of the things that you folks will have an opportunity to do is grow. You will grow as a young man, a young lady, an adult. Your span of the people that you meet, the things you are going to do as a volunteer firefighter, the sky is the limit. One of the greatest things for me as a past chief and as a deputy coordinator here in the town was last year being able and being asked to head up a task force with Chief Sullivan from West Albany to go to the town of Conklin during the floods.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we're not serving our community. Our community was asked to go and help another community.
Right.
There was nothing more gratifying for us to travel 150 miles to the southern tier of New York State, go into a town that was totally devastated, and have the people of that town and the appreciation from the town residents as well as the town government, the thank yous that we got, there is no money or anything that you could ever give us for what we felt in our hearts that we gave to that community,
right,
that we were able to hopefully someday, that if it ever happens here, that people will reach out across the state that are volunteers like us and help our brothers and sisters as well as the great citizens of the state of New York and pass on that training that we have received,
yep,
and give it back.
And that's kind of interesting too, because again, you think that, okay, I'm a member of a town of Colonie fire department, and you know, there's no borders. I mean, if a disaster happens someplace in the state and you have the qualifications and the training, you may be asked or you may volunteer to go to that other part of the state, or it could be another part of the country. I know that there's been some incidences where there's been departments have gone to the state of Massachusetts to help out. And I know several years ago when there was some big snowstorms out in the Buffalo area, there was members from this area went there. When we had the ice storms up north, we had membership from these town departments respond to those areas and assist. So again, it's not like you're going to be boxed into just to the town of Colonie.
Right.
There's some opportunities there to be involved in other operations. You brought up you kind of skimmed over it quick, but I think it's kind of an interesting point. You mentioned young men and young women. Are you starting to see a lot of young ladies and all the young women get involved in the fire service?
Actually, believe it or not, what we end up seeing in the fire service are college kids that come in. We have second, third, fourth generation daughters and sons that are joining the firehouse. We also are seeing a big influx of people that are in their 50s,
mm-hmm,
60 years old, that are starting to retire. They want to know, how can I help?
Mm-hmm.
And we gladly accept them right in.
So, I mean, if you took somebody in that age bracket, maybe they're not going to be an interior firefighter that's going to have to be put through a lot of physical demands. But there's a lot of exterior operations that go on. There's fire police operations. So there's a use for everybody. Anybody who wants to join the fire service, regardless of your age or maybe some physical limitations, there's probably a place for you there.
One thing that you will get from the volunteer fire service is, the only difference is we don't get a paycheck. We do the same job that a career firefighter does.
Mm-hmm.
We're professionals just as a career firefighter is. We are still professionals. We are a volunteer fire department staffed with professionals. In saying that, in the volunteer fire service, there is a place for everybody. Good, mm-hmm, bad, or indifferent, there is a place for everybody in the volunteer fire service. Whether it be on the hose line, directing traffic out in the street, supporting the people that are actually doing the firefighting. There is a role for everyone in the fire service. Why we're speaking about a role for everyone in the fire service, one of the things that we need to look at as a whole are people that, what do they have to offer? Maybe you're an attorney. Maybe you're an accountant. Maybe you could help us with our books. Maybe you could, okay, give us legal advice. Maybe you're an electrician and you can do electrical work around a firehouse versus using the taxpayer dollars to maintain the firehouse. Those people can come in and help. One of the things the residents of the town, I don't really think, realize is the town of Colonie is the second largest town in New York State. The town of Colonie emergency services, police under Chief Hyder, EMS under Chief Politis, fire services under you, are known throughout the state of New York for things that we do in the town. The town of Colonie emergency services take the leading edge on a lot of things that go on. If you watch the news, 6, 10, 13, 8, Channel 9, you watch how many times those folks come to the town, come to your office, come to Shaker Road, come to Fuller Road, go to Latham. And they're doing interviews with those folks because they are the leading edge. The town of Colonie services are known in part throughout the country, especially police. Police is one of the, made our community here under Supervisor Brazell one of the safest in the country. Mm-hmm. Chief Politis' EMS is known throughout the country for his professionalism that he has instilled in the EMS department and his people. The fire services in the town are known. We are self-supporting. We have our own hazmat team. We have our own confined space team. We have our own fast teams. We have our own folks that pretty much do everything. Colonie Village with their trench rescue. Right. Premier team, trench rescue structural collapse, known throughout New York State for what they have. But I don't think people realize in the town what they actually have. They have services in the town that have been built through the years that are known throughout the country.
I know from working with a lot of these folks, such as yourself and a lot of the departments, there's a lot of well-trained and well-dedicated individuals who really believe in what they're doing, have gone the extra mile, have taken the extra training, and I agree with you. I think that the Town of Colonie Emergency Services has excelled in many areas, and we try and stay on top of things, and we try to be on the cutting edge of stuff. And unfortunately, with the way that the world is evolving today, we've almost got to do that, because if we're not, we're going to be left behind, and we're going to end up getting people hurt in our business, or again, the taxpayers that are out there, we want to make sure we're providing the proper service for them. And with that kind of being said a little bit, you know, you mentioned before that the fire department started out several hundred years ago with bucket brigades. Times have changed, and the things that we're expected to do has changed. Can you kind of touch about some of the different other different courses that are out there, some of the specialized things? You've already mentioned confined space and the hazmat team. But we're looking at weapons of mass destruction now and bioterrorism type of incidents. And it all these type of things fall back onto the shoulders of the fire department very often. And it's our responsibility to handle these. Because when that something bad happens, those people pick up the phone and dial 911. They're expecting somebody to show up and knows what they're doing. So it's really coming back to us to be on top of this stuff and do the training. But can you just comment about some of the other disciplines that are out there now in the fire service?
Some of the other things at the fire service, as we all know, or we know, is the fire service is the 911. When you need something done, they call 911. They hope the fire department, just the fire department doesn't do this. The fire department has been asked to do so many things. It's put a training drag on the fire departments that we just don't fight fires anymore. We go to hazmat material incident calls. If there is a terrorist attack, we're expected to be able to come in and hold the line until we can bring help in that's specialized in that. So we have training with WMD, we have training with hazmat, we have, depending on the department, some training has evolved in trench rescue, confined space, structural collapse. The presidential directives that came in effect with NIMS training, and what the NIMS training was, the National Incident Management System. Mm-hmm. To make everybody be able to play on the same page. And that was a direct result after 9/11 down to the World Trade Center to bring that together and make everybody so that everyone can play together and their equipment works together. And there's a lot of training in that. And that all falls into the incident command part where we can all talk and play and work well together. Mm-hmm. It doesn't stop there, it just continues. The training is endless of what you can actually pick up in a fire service. Now, all those classes I just talked about, or that training requirement, every one of those classes that I talked about, or those training requirements are out there, guess what they are too?
All college.
They're all college credited. Yeah. So you're going to get college credit. One of the big things is, speaking of the fire services, going back to what we're expected to do, one of the things we are expected to do is respond. A lot of the residents in the town of Colonie think we're all career. Mm-hmm. Because when they see the shiny red truck and they dial 911, the folks from the fire service are there within minutes at their house to help.
Right.
What they don't realize is that those guys are all volunteers. And we need volunteers.
Absolutely.
Because the requirements that are put on the volunteers, everyone gives what they can, and we never have enough, because the training, depending on what you might want to do. You mm-hmm. want to be a fireman? Be a fireman. If you really want to specialize in being a hazmat guy, well, you can go ahead and become a hazardous materials specialist and make that your forte. Yeah. So you're not just a fireman. If you like to play in dirt, get involved with the trench rescue folks. Yeah. If you like to play with buildings that have fallen and put them back up together and brace them up, you get involved with either the USAR team mm-hmm. or Colonie Village structural collapse team,
yep.
and you build it from there.
Yeah. There's plenty of opportunities, and there's it's very diversified now, the fire service. Again, you know, way back when you used to go and put a fire out or maybe get a cat out of a tree. It's so much more than that now, and I think if you look at some of the incidents that have happened around the country, 9/11, Katrina, some of the local stuff, the big ice storms we had up north, the tornadoes here in Mechanicville, the fire departments have to be very versatile and ready to respond and work at all these type of incidents. It's not just going to put water on a fire anymore. There's so many demands and so many different things that are out there today that we have to be prepared for.
That is so true. The key thing is what you said, so many more demands and so many things that we need to be prepared for. We can never be prepared for everything, but we try.
Mm-hmm.
We try our best to be the best at what we do. If you look at the fire services again throughout the town, my department might not be great at one certain thing, but there's a department in the town that specializes right. in that. So when I need help, we call them in.
Right.
And they come in and do the job. Yeah. We can hold the line until they get yeah. there.
That's one thing that I've seen in the town of Colonie is nobody's bashful to ask for help. And I think you nailed it on the head. We all can't be experts in everything, but there are experts out there. And they always say, the smartest person is not the person that knows everything, but they know where to get everything from or who to get all the information from. And we do have those resources here. And I think the town of Colonie, the residents should be very proud of the fire service here and know that they're doing a great job for them, but understand that we're always looking for new membership. And, as time goes on, people have less and less time to give to volunteer organizations. And I think volunteer organizations in all walks of life are suffering somewhat because people don't have the time to give anymore. But if anybody's has any even remotest interest in joining the fire service, make that phone call, like Jer said, and reach out to your local firehouse and get the ball rolling.
That number that you'd want to call if you're not sure where to call would be 475-2929. That's 475-2929. And what that number does, it goes to the Albany County hotline, and there's somebody there to answer the phone. The answer the phone recruitment hotline. You tell them your name, where you live, and they will put you in contact or put the fire department in contact with you to let you know where you can come and help.
So just reiterating, that's a county-wide recruitment hotline. I mean, this is open to both fire service and EMS service, correct? Throughout the county?
Yes, it is.
So you can dial that number and they'll put you in touch with your local.
You can dial that number 24/7. Somebody's there. Take a message, get that information out, and it makes it easier for you. Most of the time what happens is that comes back to us. We reach out to you. That we got a hit, you're interested in joining, mm-hmm. we come to you and say, this is what we can offer for you. It's no longer you coming to me, this is what I can do for you.
Right.
It's what we as a service can do for you in return for your services. And that's what it's about. And it goes back to that whole family thing. It's a family. You will not understand until you actually join. And you say, geez, you know, I don't like my family now. Well, you know something, you're not always going to like everyone at the firehouse,
right.
but there's a draw there.
Yes,
there is definitely a draw for you to come and do the things that you want to do. Mm-hmm. And the requirements, once you get past your first year, everything else is a breeze. And if you can't finish your firefighter one within the first year when you started, you have 2 years from date that you started that class to get back into class and finish up what you need.
So again, if somebody has some type of family crisis or comes up or whatever the case may be, and they have to put that on the back burner for a while, that's a doable thing.
Yep. Or maybe your job time changes. Maybe you had Tuesdays and Thursdays off, and for some reason things got, there's usually another firefighter one either being run in Schenectady County, Rensselaer County, or as in Albany County, there's usually three or four that are run a year. Mm-hmm. So maybe you start one in Colonie, can't finish it, maybe you go to Gilderland.
Correct.
And we'll help you out doing that. We'll give you everything that you need as a state fire instructor to help keep you in the loop. We don't want to lose you. We want to keep you. And we want to do whatever we have to do to keep you. Because you folks, without you folks, the folks that join the fire service are the future of the fire services in the town, in the county, in the state, and throughout the country.
Okay. Chief Paris, I want to thank you very much for coming in today. I think you've brought a ton of information out to folks. I hope this answers a lot of your questions. Again, if there's ever been that thought of joining the fire department, make that call. And we gave you the hotline phone number you can call. Or take a ride down to your local firehouse and stop by some night when you see the doors open and knock on the doors and talk to the guys. And get yourself on board and get started into it. If you find it's not for you, there's no shame in walking away from it because it's not for everybody. But there's very few people that fall into that. Most people, I think, that join the fire service kind of get hooked into it, and they're there for a long time. So please, again, any questions, don't hesitate to call us. You got the hotline number. You have the number for our office, Town of Colonie Department of Fire Services. And we would also be glad to answer your questions and point you in the right direction. Thank you very much for watching.
I'm just trying to be a father, raise a daughter and a son, be a lover to their mother, everything to everyone. Up and at 'em bright and early, I'm all business in my suit. Yeah, I'm dressed up for success, from my head down to my boots. I don't do it for the money, there's bills that I can't pay. I don't do it for the glory, I just do it anyway. Providing for our futures, my responsibility. Yeah, I'm real good under pressure, being all that I can be. I can't call in sick on Mondays when the weekend's been too strong. I just work straight through the holidays, sometimes all night long. You can bet that I stand ready when the wolf growls at the door. Hey, I'm solid, hey, I'm steady, hey, I'm true down to the core. And I will always do my duty, no matter what the price. I've counted up the cost, I know the sacrifice. Oh, and I don't wanna die for you, but if dying's asking me, I'll bear that cross with honor, 'cause freedom don't come free. I'm an American soldier, an American. Beside my brothers and my sisters, I will proudly take a stand. When liberty's in jeopardy, I will always do what's right. I'm out here on the front lines, sleep in peace tonight. American soldier, I'm an American soldier. Yeah, an American soldier, sisters, I'm a proudly take a stand. When liberty's in jeopardy, I will always do what's right. I'm out here on the front line, so sleep in peace tonight. American soldier, I'm an American, an American, an American
Channel 17, the Town of Colonie Government Channel.